graduating flights. Running with the flights are the commanders, first sergeants, flight commanders, and NTIs who have helped mold the flights you see in front of you. All of the flights you will see today. First flight you see is flight 504.
Proud to recognize Airman First Man. Country of origin somewhere. Airman First Name. Country of origin somewhere. Airman First Name.
Go back.
For the arms.
Relax your arms.
Airman First Name somewhere. Country of origin. Airman First Name. Country of origin somewhere.
Yeah.
graduates will be coming on as they serve our great nation in the years to come. This week, we have a special opportunity to recognize one additional and significant achievement, demonstrating the dedication of 12 of our graduates from completing our process to become citizens of the United States of America. Today's recognition is made possible by Airman Chokon Jones, country of origin, Iberia. Airman Andrea Minor, country of origin, Netherlands. Veterans and military members without uniform, they render salute or place their right hand over their heart. Now marching into position, like 504, Red Belt, Technical Sergeant Juan Santos Pedraza Jr., military training instructor, Bolton, Manhattan, Connecticut. Technical Sergeant Richard Thompson, military training instructor, hometown, Eagle One. Like, I'm on hold. Like, Technical Sergeant Travis Robinson, Military Sergeant Jordan. These individuals have been enhanced to perform for today's ceremony. In addition to completing all basic military training syllabus and training requirements, Drum and Bugle Corps members will commit additional training hours or practice throughout their weeks of training. Their extra effort and commitment demonstrate teamwork and the Air Force's core values and reinforce others. With each Drum and Bugle Corps performance, they honor the plan of the long-standing tradition of live music and formal military ceremony.
I'm incredibly proud of how far you've come. Keep preparing, keep growing. Build your mental toughness and your resiliency, there's no doubt. We will hear about all the extraordinary things that you do very soon. Thank you for your service and the sacrifices you will certainly make. My family and I are so thankful for you. It's because of you and the 1% of society that volunteer. All graduation requirements and are recommended to Colonel Wilson and Chief Master Sergeant Anderson that you receive your company airman's point, which signifies your transition today from trainees to airmen. Congratulations.
ladies and gentlemen, Senator Kirk Peterly.
Grandparents, spouses, significant others, all of those in attendance on this beautiful and extremely humid Texas summer day in support of our graduates. It's great to see so many in attendance. A special shout out to all those wearing the purple swag. You look awesome. Love seeing that in the crowd. Today, I have the great privilege to introduce 637 of the Air Force's newest airmen, all knights of the 324th Training Squad. First, to our guests in attendance, today is likely bittersweet. While I'm sure you are proud of your loved one's accomplishments, there are likely many of you with some degree of hesitation or even nervousness